So the first thing that comes to mind is that I think that some people might feel a little too precious about this book. I mean, it really actually is quite beautiful, I have to say, as the artist. I'm not necessarily a colorer. I am an artist. I studied art at university at Davis in California. And we were taught that we would just not take things so, you know, that not so seriously, not get too precious about things. So I think the idea is to have enough sort of preciousness, but not get too carried away with the idea. And if we make mistakes, we make mistakes, and, you know, it's just coloring. So we need to have a sharp pencil, that is for sure. And I like this metal sharpener. I'm new to coloring, really, other than doing it as a kid. Artists sometimes fine artists can be kind of brutal. I'm a bit brutal, so I'm trying to learn to be a little bit more delicate. All right, so I'm looking at this. You can see now the four circles that go around. Okay, so I want to have some of that layering visible. I want the center to glow. And let's see, I'm going to go ahead and just start with my favorite color, 924 Rouge Cramoisi, I think is how you say that. And then I like to have a little piece of paper here to kind of keep my hand from destroying it. Where did it go? Okay, I'm just gonna start by going in and just giving everything sort of a light layer. And we're gonna work this up, so don't freak out. I'm not gonna be coloring this light. The entire time. Thank you. See, when I put the rouge over the grayscale, it actually kind of looks pretty much the same as this. I'm not real sure. Let's see what this does. Now, see, it's a little bit more interesting there. I'm gonna go ahead and take it really dark right there. So eventually that's what we're gonna wanna get across the whole design. You see how there's just no paper at all. And it builds up kind of like a waxy surface, and it feels pretty good. It feels cool actually, and you can kind of shine it a little bit too. It feels quite satisfying, I must say. So let's see. Did that there. And I like it better layered over the rouge and the pink like that. It has a more sort of ruby look, or jewel look, I guess. I guess rubies are a little darker. Lighter. And I meant this to be sort of a meditation, so the idea is that one would think about their root chakra as they color this. So we want ruby colors, glowy colors. Yeah, that looks pretty good in there. I'm not gonna get all the way though, because I want to have some room to blend. Okay. Want these to be dark in here too. You can see the artist originally put this because she wanted to have sort of a deeper look there. Okay. All right, let's see what we've done here. Come back in with our crimson. No, CRAMOISI. See what happens here. And I am coming in quite a bit darker, blending. And out. And I think I like the way that looks. Yeah. It looks quite nice. Like it. Then I keep some sort of soft rag around to kind of, and then also to. Mm-hmm. All right, let's do the next one. Sharper pencil, but we'll see what I can do here. The idea is to sort of feather in and then as you come up to the line, the idea is to come just right up to it with a lighter touch. So you go heavier, heavier, lighter, 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 lighter. Lighter all the way up to the line. So that's a little bit better lining than I did in the previous picture.
Okay, and I like this kind of fade. That looks pretty good. Coloring in. I think I'll put some, I like the way this turned out, so I'm gonna do the whole outer section here, all of these outer sections. Nubs of this pencil, of this color. I think I like this color. The good thing about coloring the chakras is that each of the colors will be equally represented. The ROUGE bib. Well, let me start over here because I feel more certain about this. Because I like that brightness. That's easy for me to see right now. Thank you. let's see what happens here. A little too sharp for this, you know, to be a little softer. This one quite dark. So let's try. The rouge, Tuscan rouge. Just enough for a little bit of red to come over of the crimson to come over. I keep calling it crimson, it's cramoisi. Who comes up with these names anyway, huh? See what happens. What if a little too purple looking. I'll come in with, you know what, my favorite color to kind of unite it all. What happened here? That looks kind of like that. See how you really can layer quite a bit with the Prismacolor. That's what I like about it. You can do a lot of correcting, or not a lot, but you can do some correcting, adjusting. Not that it was wrong, it's just that I didn't like it. Brutal. Okay, I'm liking that. I think next I'd like to come in with some ink and do some sort of glazy sort of thing over here, and then finish up with blackening the lines. However, I am realizing that I need to give the I need to give the lines some color. So I'm gonna start with just a yellow, just to give it a base, because I learned my lesson from the last picture that it really does just seem to behave better. There is a layer of pencil underneath before I do the pen. And I need a sharp pencil. Verge Dior. Door? 1034. Maybe it's just more noticeable. See, to do it around in these areas too. Sort of like glazes, or just to brighten areas. Right, actually. Let's go right in the center. Let's see what happens with this one. I'm going to blend it a little bit. Works. The black line a little darker to have a little color on it. But I did learn on the last one not to do too much of that, because when I come in with the pencil, I don't want to, I don't know, this is like a little too much media. Now, do I want to go over that or no? I like the way this goes. Just going to keep that. I'm going to continue it in there. Continue it over here. These are just cheap loft pens, artist loft. I'm not seeing a color name. I'm pretty happy with this. Let's just see what happens if I put red over these. This one. Deep, nice rich color. See what happens when it dries though. It may not be as rich. It's a pretty good start, and these are some ideas of what we can do with these pictures. And
so I'm pretty happy with the way this turned out. I think I'd like maybe just a little bit more red on the tips coming down in here.
Techniques.
I'd like to work on these lines. I'm going to start with a darker red and then move out to a darker black. And I actually like the way the gold line looks. I think I'm going to leave that pretty much intact. So let's start with this red pen. I just want to bring a little bit more. Do I want to do this? Yes, I do. I want to blend it with some pink. What I want.
happens if I put the red on top of that? Mm-hmm. Maybe blend it with a little bit more yellow. Don't like that so much. It's not bad. Pencil. Look at these lines. And so it's the same thing that we talked about earlier. I wanna come in a little dark here and then fade to the edge. Curved ones, you just have to be a little bit fearless. But these you can be. Pretty good. So here's where I thought maybe I'd make some decisions. Maybe I will use the black, and just lightly and then darker, and darker, and then lighter. I like that. And do I want to do that one? So I think it's pretty much done. Pretty happy with it. Better attract something. Hopefully something. good. Need to do something there. To the left. Give it a shadow. Under. And to the left. They need some help. Maybe you should help them out. Brighten them up. I like it very much.
And that is that for that one. And here's the other one. And I actually like the other one too. They both have their unique qualities. I might go in and really enhance the black on the first one. And now that I'm looking at the second one, I might do more gold on the second one. I think it's a pretty good start, and these are some ideas of what we can do with these pictures, and I would love to hear from you and get some help with my coloring skills and techniques, and I look forward to coloring the rest of the book.